Good morning. In the last lecture, we have briefly discussed about the vibrations, and we have just given a glimpse of what are the various topics that we cover under the vibrations in this unit. And at that moment, we have talked about two types of vibrations. One is called free vibration and another one is called forced vibration. Okay, we made a classification of vibrations in a different categories. Like one of the classification is free vibration and forced vibration. So today's lecture, we will see how to find out the natural frequency of a free vibration. Okay, so let me repeat in 2 minutes what we have discussed about free vibration and how we distinguished with forced vibration. After looking that part, then we will go for the finding the value of natural frequency of a free vibration by using 3 different methods. That is, one is called equilibrium method, that is also called a Newton's method, and the second one is energy method, and third one is a Rayleigh's method. So that we will see today's lecture. As I said, the difference between free vibration and forced vibration is, if a body is in a steady state or in a static condition or in equilibrium condition, if you disturb its steady state or its equilibrium state, okay, then it starts moving the body. So this movement of the body will moves continuously. Actually, according to Newton's first law, that body has to continuously move in the same fashion, or it has to vibrate with the same fashion what it has started. But in realistic life, it will not happen. So after some time, it comes to the rest. Okay, this is the phenomena which is very well known to all of us. So here we will distinguish a vibration called free vibration and forced vibration is like this. If you give an initial displacement or initial force to a body to vibrate and allow to swing without adding additional force or additional displacement subsequently, that is called a free vibration. A vibration is said to be free. Give an initial displacement or an initial force is given to the body and allowed to vibrate. Okay, so it vibrates continuously and it comes to the rest, of course, after some time. If you don't add any additional force or any additional displacement to that system, such a vibration is called free vibration. The other one, forced vibration, is a one where we will continuously feed the energy or the displacement to the moving body so that it will not come to the rest. It will be continuously oscillating. That is another vibration called forced vibration. So the body which moves with a certain frequency under free vibration is called a natural frequency. So let me repeat, natural frequency is nothing but it is the frequency of a body which vibrates under free vibration. Okay, so today we will see how to find out natural frequency of a free vibration. So there are 3 methods are there. The first one is Newton's method. And the same is called as equilibrium method. And the second one is energy method. Third one is Rayleigh's method. Third one is Rayleigh's method. All of the 3 methods will give the same solution, but the approach is different in Newton's method, and it is different in the energy method, and it is different in the Rayleigh's method. The final solution, all in all the cases, you will get the same. So let us first focus on the first one, that is equilibrium method. Let us take a spring of stiffness K, okay, with a free length of say L. So this is the stiffness K with a free length of L. A spring is taken with stiffness K. Stiffness is taken K with a free length of L. Suppose if this spring is added with a mass okay, so if it is added with some mass, that is W, which is mg, then it will deform certain amount, so the free length is increased, so it is elongated by an amount of delta. So it is elongated by an amount of delta. So it is elongated by an amount of delta. Okay. Then if I give a displacement, external displacement x. So if I give a displacement to this body, so from this position to this position, mean position, if I give a displacement of x, okay, so these are the three states of the conditions which I am showing. Originally it is free length of L, okay, with a stiffness of K. The same spring is added with a mass of W, which causing a deformation of delta, and subsequently I am applying a displacement, an external displacement by an amount of x, and now the new position of this mass is reached to in another location here. W, this is the location. Okay, so now let us see how to find out the natural frequency of this particular case. Okay, now if you write here the equilibrium condition, if you write here the equilibrium condition, so the downward force mg is equated to the upward force, this is k delta. So in this case, that is when it is added with a mass m, so the downward force mg is balanced by the upward force, the spring force is k delta. And here, say this is given a displacement of x, okay, and there will be a spring force of k plus delta x, okay, in the upward direction and downward direction mg, and m d square x by dt square. D square x by dt square is the accelerating force. Okay, so these are the three conditions, three states of location you can see. Now I will write the first one. What is the restoring force? Restoring force. So the restoring force is equal to W minus K into delta plus X. So the restoring force, the body which restores it, is W minus K into delta plus X. So that is W minus K delta minus KX. So what is the W? W is mg. Okay, and this is minus k delta minus kx. And we know mz is equal to k delta from the second condition. So if I replace it like k delta minus k delta minus kx. So k delta cancel, then it is called minus kx. So the restoring force is minus kx. Then what is the accelerating force? Accelerating force is equal to m into d square x by dt square. So it is a customary practice in vibrations, x is written for displacement and x dot is written for velocity, which is dx by dt, and x double dot is d square x by dt square. This is for acceleration. This is the customary practice in the vibrations. So x dot is velocity, x double dot is acceleration, that is the d square x by dt square. X is the displacement. So for the equilibrium condition is concerned, the restoring force should be equal to accelerating force. So that is restoring force is equal to accelerating force. So restoring force, what we have seen is minus kx, which is accelerating force is md square x by dt square. Okay, so if you rearrange this, then we get md square x by dt square plus kx is equal to 0. We can also rearrange this d square x by dt square plus k by m into x is equal to 0. Okay, so we can rewrite assuming k by m is equal to omega square. So this equation will convert as d square x by dt square plus omega square x is equal to 0. Okay, so d square x by dt square plus omega square x is equal to 0. This is the equation for equilibrium condition. Okay, so we can write omega square is k by m, or omega is equal to root k by m. What is k? K is the stiffness of the spring and m is the mass of the spring. Okay, so we can also write the time period is nothing but 2 pi by omega. So 2 pi by root k by m. Okay, so that is 2 pi root m by k. Time period is equal to tp is equal to 2 pi root m by k. So then this is also can be written as, in the other way, frequency is 1 by time period. So that is 1 by time period is 1 by 2 pi root m by k. Okay, so this gives 1 by 2 pi root k by m. So 1 by 2 pi root k by m. So this frequency, which is called natural frequency, because we defined a natural frequency is one, the body which vibrates with a certain frequency by disturbing initially and allowing to vibrate its own. So that is what the natural frequency, then this f can be simply written as fn. Fn is equal to 1 by 2 pi root k by m. So the same thing can be written in the other way. So you can see here what is k by m here. From here mg is equal to k by k delta. So we can write k by m is equal to k by m is equal to this is g by delta. So I will replace it 1 by 2 pi k by m is by 1 by 2 pi root g by delta. So the natural frequency of a free vibration, is written as fn is equal to 1 by 2 pi root g by delta. So you can observe here the natural frequency is not function of the displacement what you have given, isn't it? So you can find this a simple this equation. The natural frequency is not function of the displacement what you have given, because it is only function of acceleration due to the gravity and its own displacement due to self weight. Okay, so the natural frequency of a body varies if there is a acceleration due to gravity varies, otherwise the natural frequency will not vary. So what is the amount of displacement that you provide, it doesn't matter. That is why you can see, even if you give a large amount of the displacement for a body and it takes some time to come to the rest, similar small amount of displacement is given to the same body, it comes to the rest in the same time, not with a different time. Only what you can see, the decay is a different. So if you indicate that like a diagram for time versus displacement, in one case this is the time versus displacement. If you draw a time versus a displacement, like one undergoes like this, large displacement is given and it takes some time, that time is this. In the other case, you give the displacement but a smaller amount, so this also will take same amount of time to come to the rest. Okay, but the difference is here the amplitude decay, here it is more and here it is less, but ultimately the natural frequency is same. Okay, so that is what you can see, fn is equal to 1 by 2 pi root g by delta. So we know that the value of g is equal to 9.81. if you substitute that 9.81, then we get we can also write fn is equal to, if you substitute g 9.81, then fn is equal to 0.4985 by root delta hex. So by substituting the g value 9.81, that is in meters per second square, okay, meters per second square, then the delta, if you substitute in meters, then you get fn is equal to 0.4985 by 85 by root delta hertz. That is the first one using the equilibrium method. Then we will see the two other methods, that is energy method and Rayleigh's method. Same thing can be proved. Delta is in meters. Delta is in meters. Just now we have seen the equilibrium method, and using that method we have calculated the natural frequency of a free vibration, okay, in a longitudinal mode. Now we will see the second method, which is called energy method. which is called energy method. So what is the origin for this energy method? You are aware of one basic fundamental part in the physics. So the total energy is constant. So the energy can be converted into one form to the other form, and energy cannot be destroyed. So the kinetic energy can be converted into potential energy, or potential energy can be converted into kinetic energy. But the sum of the total energy is constant, and the rate of change of energy is equal to zero. That is the simple concept we use here. That is d by dt of kinetic energy plus potential energy is equal to zero. Kinetic energy plus potential energy is equal to zero. That is d by dt of ke plus pe is equal to zero. So let me write what is the kinetic energy and what is the potential energy. You know kinetic energy is equal to half mv square, that is half m velocity v is dx by dt, so half mv square. Then what is potential energy? So potential energy is the mean force into the displacement, mean force into displacement, because here under zero condition two, it is going to move to a maximum condition. That is the displacement is given gradually. So we take the mean force and its displacement product is a potential energy. So how to get this? What is the mean force? Initial force is zero and final force is kx. Then mean force is equal to 0 plus kx by 2, and displacement is given by an amount of x. So the diagram is same diagram which I have drawn for the previous one, that is applicable here also. So which is equal to half kx square. Okay, so kx by 2 into x is equal to half kx square. So let me write, this is d by dt of half m dx by dt whole square plus half kx square is equal to zero. So differentiate with respect to time, half m which is constant, then dx by dt square is two times of dx by dt. And dx by dt with reference to d by dt is d square x by dt square. Then half kx square, k is a constant, then x square 2x, then x dx by dt is equal to 0. So then you can cancel half 2 dx by dt, dx by dt. Then what is the equation, the remaining equation? D square x by dt square, d square by x dt square into m plus kx is 0. Or this can also written d square x by dt square, okay, by k by m into x is equal to 0. So this is same thing you have seen, that is in the earlier part also, that is md square x by dt square, md square x by dt square plus kx is equal to 0, or d square x by dt square plus k by mx is 0, or d square x by dt square. So k by m we have written omega square x, which is equal to 0. Okay, so the same equation, whatever the equation you got earlier, the same equation you have obtained here also. That is what energy method. So you can write in the similar manner, what is the time period, what is the natural frequency, okay, everything in the similar method. So that is the next method. Okay, then coming to the last method, what is Rayleigh's method? So this is the third method. This is the third method, which is called a Rayleigh's method. So this also uses the same principle of the above principle, but it will be delivered in the other way. So what we said, that the total energy is a constant. So the rate of change of energy is equal to zero. That means one energy is converted into the another energy. That means suppose if one energy is at minimum, then other energy will be maximum. That means if kinetic energy is zero, means potential energy will be maximum. When the potential energy is zero, kinetic energy will be maximum. So that concept here we use, that is Ke max is equal to Pe max. What is Ke, Pe? Ke is the kinetic energy, Pe is the potential energy. So let me take the vibration equation, like x is equal to capital X sine omega t. That means x is the displacement at any instant, which is given by an amplitude of x with an angular frequency of omega with a time period of t. So x is the displacement at any time, which is given by capital X is the amplitude and omega is the angular frequency, the time period is the t. So we can write dx by dt, that is x dot is x sine omega t cos omega t omega, that is x omega cos omega t. Then d square by x dt square, that is x double dot is equal to d by dt of x omega cos omega t, that is x omega cos omega t minus sin omega t. So omega t omega, so this gives minus x omega square sin omega t. So x dot is equal to x omega cos omega t, and x double dot is minus x omega square sin omega t. So let us write what is the Ke max and Pe max. When the Ke max is at mean position. So Ke max is at mean position. So what is the Ke max at mean position? So Ke max is equal to, we know that half into mv square. So v is the velocity, is nothing but x dot, that is half m x dot square. So what is the maximum of x dot? X dot max is, x dot max is cos omega t max is x omega. So that is nothing but half into m into, so x omega whole square. Similar Pe max, what is the Pe max? So when the Pe max will takes place, Pe max will be at extreme positions. So Pe max is at extreme positions, at extreme positions, it will be equal to half kx square. That is what we have written earlier, that is 0 plus kx by 2 into displacement x, that is kx by 2 into x, that is kx square by 2. So this is x is x max. So half k x max. What is the x max? So here x is the x sine omega t. So x max is equal to amplitude of x. So we can write it is half kx square. Okay, so as per the basic equation which we have written, ke max is equal to pe max. Let me write this is half. I will write here. So I will continue here. That is half ke max is equal to pe max. Half, how much it is? M x square omega square is equal to half k x square. So half of get cancel, x square can cancel. Then you get m omega square is equal to k, or omega square is equal to k by m, or omega is equal to root k by m. This is what we have started in the very beginning in equilibrium state of condition, equilibrium condition. So we get the same thing whether it is Rayleigh's method or whether it is energy method or it is an equilibrium method. We get the same thing, that is omega square is equal to k by m or omega is equal to k by m. That gives the time period is t pi by omega, and fn is equal to 1 by time period, that is 1 by 2 pi root k by m. So fn we get fn we get tp is 2 pi omega, and its reciprocal is fn, and that fn is equal to 1 by 2 pi root k by m. So this is what time period, this is time period, okay, and fn is 1 by 2 p, tp is equal to 1 by 2 pi root k by m, or fn is equal to, that gives 2 pi root m by k. So fn is equal to 2 pi root m by k. So this is the methodology that is adopted to find out natural frequency of a free vibration in a longitudinal vibrations, that is using three different methods: equilibrium method, then energy method, and Rayleigh's method. Finally we get the same solution, time period, that is tp is 1 by 2 pi root k by m, and fn is equal to 2 pi root m by k. Okay, we'll continue in the next lecture to find out the natural frequency of torsional vibrations as well as the transverse vibrations. Thank you.